Well, hello everyone. My name is Hannah Sanchez. I'm an expanded practicing dental hygienist at Above Dental, and I hear you all are seniors this year. Does that sound about right? Some are? Okay. Well, that's pretty exciting. You've got a lot of plans ahead of you from here on out. But I'm here to talk to you guys about the dental hygiene career pathway in case anyone here is interested. All right. So you guys have a very fancy school, so would you just bear with me a little bit as I figure this all out, okay? You can see me looking at my phone and hearing a few notes or reading a few notes. So I'll be back and forth, okay? All right. So how many here know what a dental hygienist does? Yeah, you got it. So we do clean teeth, but we do much more than just clean teeth, okay? We also come up with comprehensive treatment plans for treating periodontal diseases and preventing periodontal diseases and treating cavities. So we treat and prevent dental periodontal infections by removing infectious endotoxins and helping develop personalized home care routines. We also work alongside dentists for restorative treatment, and most important part of our job is education, and educating patients on the effect of oral health and how it impacts overall health. So what is periodontal disease? It's a little different. It's different than cavities because it involves not only the tooth structure but the tissues surrounding the teeth. So that could include the ligaments of the teeth, the bone surrounding the teeth, and the root surface of the tooth called the dentin. So it starts off by a reversible infection called gingivitis. You guys have probably heard of it. And with time, if it's untreated, it may lead to periodontitis, which is an irreversible infection that can cause damage to the tissue surrounding the teeth. It may cause the bone to disintegrate. It may get rid of the ligaments of the bone, the ligaments of the tooth, and may eventually cause the tooth to become wiggly and then fall out. So, not some very fun stuff. Okay. And so, the pros and cons of dental hygiene. So there are some pros and cons to dental hygiene, but I'll start with the pros. A lot of healthcare jobs are not known to be very flexible with their hours, but dental hygiene is really nice because you get to really choose what hours you want to work and how long you want to work. So it is very flexible. You can also get, not a lot of dental offices are open during the holidays. So you more than likely will get holidays off, and most of the time it's paid. And the career is very high demand, especially along the coast. It's much harder to have dentists and hygienists stay around in this area. So if you did choose to pursue dental hygiene around this area, you wouldn't have a hard time finding a job, which is really great. Another pro is that it keeps you busy all the time. So there's always something to do when you're in the dental office. If you're a busy bee and you don't like just sitting there, it's a perfect career choice. And what's really nice about dental hygiene is when the patient's in your chair, you really get to make a difference. So you try to do your hardest and clean all the infectious toxins off before the patients out of your chair, and once they're out of your chair, it's up to you, the patient, to make sure they're getting taken care of at home. But with that, you get to see patients every 6 months or possibly every 3 to 4 months as well, which allows you the opportunity to have good patient-clinician relationships, and really, you get to know your patients, and it's a lot of fun. A few cons is that it's really hard on your body. There's times where you're using a lot of these small muscles that you wouldn't normally that is very difficult and hard, hard on your back, on your neck. So dentists and dental hygienists, dental assistants, they're prone to different musculoskeletal disorders that with time can cause them to retire early. So that's a big con, but with good ergonomics, it can help prevent that and mitigate that risk. Another con, which is also a pro I put on there, is it does keep your work, it keeps you busy. So a lot of times, there's not a lot of time to do a whole lot of things. So you're working, once you clock in, you're working until you're done. So lunchtime is, sometimes it can get so busy that, you know, you gotta get things done before you get to take care of yourself, which it's a lot of that is pretty common in healthcare jobs, but it's very rewarding. It's also very time sensitive, so you wanna make sure that you do the best you can with the time that you have with patients, and but also keeping in mind that you want to stay on schedule. The last con I have there is the program to get into dental hygiene is more on the competitive side. So it's not uncommon to have to reapply more than once. So where can you work as a dental hygienist? So there's a few options that you have. You can go through the associate's route or you can go through the bachelor's degree route. The most common place for dental hygienists to work is a private dental office. But they also work around schools, managed care clinics such as Advantage Dental or OHP clinics, public health clinics. They're more common in larger cities. So an example of that would be like the Salem Clinic up in Salem. They are also starting to work more in hospitals, and that's they're doing more trials in bigger cities, but that's starting to be a more common thing as well, which is really neat. But also long-term care facilities like nursing homes, military clinics, and for those of you wanting to go the bachelor's degree route, you can also do teaching at a university for dental schools, dental hygiene schools, and dental assisting schools. You also can help administer public health and community-based health programs, and you just come up with those. You can do managing dental practices and different healthcare facilities as well. You can do marketing for dental supplies, products, and equipment, and also conduct research. So, is dental hygiene a good fit for you? A few traits of a good dental hygienist include being understanding and patient. You have a lot of patients in your chair that can have some anxiety or have just bad experiences in the past in a dental setting, and they may be, a lot of the people that are in your chair, they most likely don't want to be there. So being able to be understanding of that and making them feel as comfortable as they can is more appreciated. Also being detail oriented, so is a good trait because you're in the mouth, and the mouth is such a small place, and a lot of times cavities can be small. Different oral lesions like cancer, you have to be on the lookout for different things like that. Things to be able to point out to the dentist so that he can look further into and just so he can help prevent these diseases. Being good with your hands or hand movement for the same reason, the mouth is so small, and even the slightest nudge can cause sensitivity, tissue trauma. So being good with the hands is gonna be helpful. But also being passionate about about dental hygiene. That'll make things more interesting. The patient will be able to trust you better because you're passionate about what you do. And also having a positive attitude, because there'll be times where you'll have a patient that probably hasn't had a good day, and they want to be able to, you want to make sure that they feel good when they're in the chair. So giving them a smile, being, again, understanding and patient with them, so that you guys can go on with the appointment and get them taken care of. So how to become a dental hygienist. So about a year or two from, depending on how aggressive you want to tackle those and get those out of the way, then you want to apply to a dental hygiene program. Once you apply, you can cross your fingers and hope you get in the first try. And then after that, just completing the degree at that dental hygiene school. Depending on what you're interested, you could do the associate's route or the bachelor's route, which is 3.5 years versus 2 years. And then after that, you want to make sure you take your national board exams, a clinical examination, and pass those, and then submit your application to the Oregon Board of Dentistry. Once you receive your license, you then want to make sure you are participating in continuing education courses. And that can, the amount of credits can differ, can be different depending on if you do associates versus bachelors. So that was it. Any questions, you guys? I have some information for those of you that are interested. Here are some different dental hygiene schools in Oregon, and it has their contact information here so that you can get more information on their course specific, or their program specifically. And a lot of different schools will have different prerequisite courses, so making sure you do your homework and find a program that kind of matches your lifestyle, I guess I should say, would be important as well. So, any questions?
What is the average attempt of somebody to get into dental hygiene school? You said luckily, you get off the try.
Generally, if you're really, you know, wanting to get into it, it's 1 to 3.
Okay.
1 to 3 times. But it's generally a year wait to be able to reapply. But I haven't heard anyone having to apply more than 3 times.
Okay. Is it more like a space issue of the schools, or maybe grades?
It could be a combination of things. So different programs require different prerequisites to get in. So they'll look at things like your grades. They'll look at things like your past history. You'll have to do more than likely a personal essay, and they see if this is going to be a good fit for you to be a hygienist. They'll do an interview. There's a process. There is an application process, but it will differ depending on which program you decide to go to.
How many programs are there in
Oregon? Oh boy, 5 it looks like. So there's 5 programs, and generally they accept around 19 to 20 people. Mm-hmm. And I know for sure that the bachelor degree programs are the Oregon Institute of Technology and Pacific University. And then we have Lane Community College, which offers an associate's, and Mount Hood Community College that also offers an associate's degree. So I guess there's 4, but Oregon Tech is a little different because they have a campus in Salem and they have a campus in Klamath Falls.
And then
you
can go over the difference between a dental assistant versus a hygienist,
sure.
Like, is there like a pay and an education difference?
Yeah, so pay-wise, I'm not sure how much a dental assistant would get paid, but it's less than a hygienist. The dental assistant will help the doctor. So I like to use a comparison. It's a nurse versus like a nurse practitioner. Dental hygienists have more control over the appointment with their patients, treatment plans. A dental assistant is helping the nurse or helping the dentist with their treatment. So they're getting them set up. They're doing their pre-procedure. They're doing their pre-procedures. They're going over treatment plans with them. So they're there to help the doctor. Dental hygienists have more of a free range of what types of treatments. And for gum disease, dental hygienists are more like gum specialists in that comparison. Does that help?
And then what's the education difference?
For dental assistants, there's an option between going into a dental office and being trained hands-on with the dentist, or going through a program such like the one here in SWAP. So I believe their program's about a year long. It's about a year long. So schooling-wise, dental hygiene can be 2 to 4. Assisting can be, I believe it's 1 to 2, depending on if they want to have more credits to expand their license.